And maybe this was all part of the negotiation to begin with the union. I don't know if that's the case or not. But we're joined this morning by Rachel Gresler. She is a research fellow in economics, budget, and entitlements at the Heritage Foundation. And this caught my attention because Rachel has put together a piece on the fact that this GM strike, could speak to union power and the fact that it's dragged on this long. Rachel, good morning to you.
Good morning, Mark.
Great to have you on again. And what is your take on why we haven't seen a quicker resolution to this General Motors strike?
Well, I think they're trying to strong-arm the companies into doing something that they simply can't. They don't have the insight that these plants do into how to run their business, and they're trying to push costs higher than is sustainable. And in the end, that's going to end up costing workers their jobs instead of gaining them higher compensation and benefits. And so I think the fact that it's dragging on this long says that GM, they simply can't afford these higher costs that the union is trying to push onto them.
Yeah. You were, one of the quotes I read in here was that the union bosses might be partially to blame for this because, I read when this thing first started that, well, if General Motors had just come forward with this latest proposal earlier, we might have been able to avoid this. Well, what does that mean? For the people on the picket line who aren't drawing a paycheck, this is a big deal.
Right. And so you have the bosses that are sitting there and they've got all the dues and they're collecting their pay. And, some of that was involved in corruption last year in a scandal where millions of dollars were misspent that were supposed to be going towards workers, but they weren't. And so you have these union officials that are leading the negotiations and they're sitting there comfortable. And yet it's their workers who are going by on $250 a week of strike pay and they can't make ends meet. It's simply a gap between those officials up there who really aren't the on the line manufacturing workers, and it just shows that they don't really have their best interests in mind, or maybe they don't even understand them to begin with because they're in a totally different world.
I'm from a union family. My dad was a union steel worker for many years in Ohio. I was a member of a union for a number of years, and I've argued from that point of view that in many ways some of these unions, while they played a key role when they first started back in the 20s and 30s, they kind of signed their own death warrant in a lot of cases because businesses started looking in Mexico and other places because labor is their biggest expense. And that hasn't changed today any more than it did in the 1970s.
No, exactly. And there was definitely a point for unions in this country and where they were very beneficial and the workers needed them. They didn't have the protections that they have today and they needed safer working conditions. They did need fair pay, and that was in a totally different environment where we weren't in a globally competitive economy. And yet in today's world, there's just less value to workers in being part of a union. And what it ends up doing is sometimes hurting them because the unions are establishing these rigid pay scales that don't let the companies reward workers for higher productivity. And they're locking them into these higher costs that end up making the companies raise their costs, their prices, and then they can't sell as much of their products. And that's what's happened in auto manufacturing. We're at half the level of U.S.-made cars as we were two decades ago because they're pushing into other countries and having the manufacturing occur there.
True. Rachel Gresler, our guest from the Heritage Foundation, she's a research fellow there in economics. I looked at a new pickup truck on the lot the other day, $44,000, and that was at some steep discount, supposedly, right? I'm thinking to myself, you've got to be doing okay in life if you're going to take on the equivalent of a small mortgage to drive one of these trucks. And what drives that cost, part of it has to be one of the disputes in this strike right now is the cost that the unions are contributing for health care.
Right. I mean, it's not just the wages that are paid. It's this whole compensation package, and health care is huge, and so is pensions. And that's where the unions have really pushed things to the brink. Back when the bailouts happened in 2008 and 2010, pay for the big three Detroit automakers, total compensation was over $70 per hour compared to less than half of that at the foreign auto manufacturers that were located in the U.S. And so they've just pushed things too high. And on top of these high compensation costs, you're also dealing with increased prices due to the fuel economy standards that are out there. So it's really raising prices of cars, and it makes it harder for consumers to afford them. And then you've also got the whole Uber and Lyft and other alternatives that are out there. And so thinking longer term, you know, this production and car manufacturing in the U.S. and even car ownership could potentially decline even further.
True. Yeah, it's a great point. Rachel, all food for thought. We appreciate your time this morning. Thank you.
Thanks, Mark.
You bet. Heritage.org is the website. You can go read more on that. It's important. I hope that these union leaders can see past their own short-sighted goals here. Remember, a lot of these folks are going to turn right around and want to urge all of their members to vote Democrat in the next election as well. And that's playing a role here. They need to get this thing settled because I know a lot of the folks that work at that plant out there in Wentzville listen to this program. And a lot of them voted for Donald Trump in 2016 and will again. 314-241-9797. We're going to talk some Schilt when we come back with Tom Ackerman. We'll be right back.
You're listening to the Marc Cox Morning Show.
It's 8:45 and 64 degrees at 97.1 FM Talk. I'm Denise Schaefer, and here are a few of the local stories we're following this morning. The Cardinals will take on the Nationals in the NLCS after beating the Braves 13-1 last night. Game 1 at Busch Stadium tomorrow night at 7:08. The family of St. Louis Police Officer Caitlin Alex, who was shot and killed by another officer, has filed a wrongful death lawsuit. In sports, the Blues take on the Senators in Ottawa tonight at 6:30. It's 8:45 at 97.1 FM Talk.
Traffic from the Ambassador Floor Company Traffic Center.
Eastbound 70 drivers, still a slow go for you from the Blanchette Bridge to just east of 270, where the left lane and shoulder are blocked by this accident. Now, west of there, things are fine, and east, it looks fine into downtown. Westbound 70, a little slow at Jennings Station. Westbound 6440, a little bit of volume at Hampton, but nothing too terrible. Eastbound is slow, 170 through Big Bend. Northbound 270 has yet to unwind. Heavy traffic just north of 21 through Doherty Ferry. And eastbound 44, still a little bit slow through the construction zone headed for 270. No problems, though, on the bridges downtown for drivers headed in from Illinois. I'm Sue Thomas with traffic. It's 8:46 at 97.1 FM Talk.
Jerry Kelly, Heating and Air Conditioning. There's a certified technician, I've been told, to help you when it's hot and help you when it's cold. JerryKelly.com. JerryKelly.com.
JerryKelly.com.
Love the fact that it's time for the Blues to play again. When they hit the ice, one thing you're going to notice is the word Window World. You'll see the words Window World on the back of the folks down on the ice, helping clean it between periods and all that and get it prepped for the game. That's because Window World's a big sponsor, and I think that's great. They're the preferred window of the St. Louis Blues. So when it's time to shop for a new front door or a new rear entry door of some sort or windows, who are you going to call? You're going to call Window World. WindowWorld.com, 314-993-1800. They're going to come to your house. They'll give you a free estimate. I've been through this process. They put two windows in for me. They take the measurement. They go back to their factory and they build it specific to your house. And then they come back when it's installation day and they had both of these windows installed and were out of my house probably in about, I don't know, probably a little over an hour. It was amazing. I thought it would take a lot longer than that. They'll do good work for you. Simply the best for less. It's Window World, 314-993-1800, windowworld.com.
Whether it's a job interview or a first date, Lady Jeans in Sunset Hills will make sure you look great for whatever's on your plate. Get a precision haircut, hot leather neck shave, and hot towel treatment for just $14. Lady Jeans in Sunset Hills on Lindbergh Boulevard, just off of Watson Road, next to St. Louis Bread Co. It's wicked awesome!
It's not something that happens very often, so you've got to take advantage now. Tiger Express Wash is giving new members the chance to sign up for unlimited washes for 3 months for just $10 a month. But you've got to sign up before October 31st. Sign up now when you take it to the Tiger for the new member special. 3 months of unlimited washes for just $10 a month. Sign up before October 31st and start enjoying the perks of being an unlimited member at Tiger Express Wash. TigerExpressWash.com.
Perfect shine in half the time.
It all starts with just one thing.
When you're buying sports equipment for your kids this fall, be sure and look at secondhand equipment first. Also, you can sell or donate that same equipment at the end of the season to Goodwill. Your donations not only put people to work, but are keeping thousands of pounds of materials out of our landfills each year. Goodwill, the original recycler. Find tips and more at onethingus.com. What's your one thing?
There's something inherently satisfying about preparing your home for winter. Battening down the hatches, protecting those you love, creating a safe, warm haven against the brutal forces of winter. At Banner Construction, we get it. That's why we offer James Hardy fiber cement siding. So tough and durable that it comes with a 30-year warranty. James Hardy has the rich look and feel of wood. No wonder it's the number one choice of luxury home builders. And Banner Construction is a James Hardy preferred specialist. The experts at Banner don't just install siding. They know design and look for every chance to add unique character to your home that will make it stand out from the rest of the block. Banner goes the extra mile, and it shows. And there's no better defense against the chill of drafty windows than new energy-efficient Pella windows. Banner is a proud Pella Window Certified contractor. Prepare your home for winter. Call Banner Construction today for haggle-free fall pricing. For a free estimate, call Banner Construction at 314-569-1050 and have a banner day.
You're listening to the Marc Cox Morning Show.
Ozuna shoots one to right. That's down, a base hit, and the Cardinals will strike first. And Marcell Ozuna stays hot.
A great sports mind like Tom Ackerman.
Baseball's really not a hard sport.
Tom Ackerman, thank you for that insight.
It is Anchor Man, not Anchor Lady.
It's like powered by coffee this morning.
Boom! We're powered by Cardinals this morning, and we've got Tom Ackerman on the line right now, KMOX Sports Director. How are you, buddy?
Oh, this coffee tastes so much better this morning, you know? It's got a little better taste to it. The air smells so much sweeter. I'm sitting outside here in St. Louis just enjoying my morning. Had a morning off with KMOX. I'm sitting here watching my dog run around the yard.
Nice.
And it was a great night. What a night. Yeah, you know, I really appreciate you all having me on, and I appreciate the listeners. I've heard a lot of feedback about this segment on this radio station,
by
the way.
And good.
One of the things I heard from one of the Cardinals people is some members of the Cardinals front office listened to this segment. And one thing that they told me when I was down in Atlanta and after they won the NL Central was that they appreciate the support that I was giving them. And I appreciate that comment very much, but I'll be honest, and I know that people on Twitter put up with some of my positive tweets and, you know, my happy tweets about the Cardinals and everything, but I honestly felt from the very beginning under Mike Schilt's guidance that this team had something special, that they had the star power to do it. And I was disappointed in the middle of the year that they were underachieving, but I really felt like if you stay the course and let the season play out, you could have yourself a winning ball club, especially with Mike Schilt guiding it, because what he did was straighten out the defense. And that was a big part of the problem over the last several years where they didn't make the playoffs. And now what you're seeing is a team that believes it can do anything. I mean, every time they go out now, it just fuels the narrative for them. They think they can go win it all. And you know what? They might not be wrong. I mean, things that have now turned their way, with Washington winning last night on a grand slam by Howie Kendrick, who for one night was toasted in St. Louis. Now he's the enemy because he'll be here as the opponent. But the Cardinals get to play tomorrow at home and Saturday at home. And the things are starting to look really nice for this team as they go after that 12th World Championship.
So let me play the Skipper's comments in the locker room last night that ended up on Instagram, and then let's talk about that.
We played the game hard, we played the game right. They started some we finished the
Yeah.
And that's how we roll. We don't start, but no one us ever. Ever. All right? Now, I don't give a who we play. We're going to take it right to him the whole way. We're
going to
kick your ass.
Yeah. Let's go! Yeah! You know what? I was so shocked by that because I think of Mike Schilt like I think of my CPA. And I have never seen that side of it before. And that I mean, he was, I think that was the locker room speech that might carry this team forward from this point. What do you think?
Yeah.